Overall, you must take tremendous satisfaction in the fact that palliative medicine is now established.
Mm-hmm.
And do you feel now will remain established as a recognised field of activity within medicine? Or do you think it's at any risk of diminishing?
No, I don't feel it's established. I feel it's contributed a lot, and I think there's a lot more to contribute. And I really do believe that at the most 10% of what we ought to know, could know, could learn, we now know. And that is no exaggeration. I think there's far more still to be learned. I'm not sure that it's going to grow and grow as it has done, because I think it's been subsumed into the overall pattern, which in a way is what we wanted. I never ever dreamed that we'd have an elite corps of doctors that would be doing palliative medicine, and everybody else would feel they didn't need to because they always had Derek Doyle and all these people to go to. That was the last thing that was in my mind. But that is what is happening. And with these huge pressures in general practice that we know about, I mean, I've had this said to me by many GPs, I would love to have been able to look after Joe Bloggs at home or home, but I couldn't have the time. Look what the government's done to us. So it's good to have a place that we can send them to. And as we all know, the percentage of people dying at home is dropping by 1% per annum in Scotland. So it's good to have you folks around. That's never what I thought at all. I thought that we should empower them, to use the modern jargon, that they would enjoy doing it. That's why we had home care services, home care teams. But I mean, I've had GPs saying to them, well, I invite them in, they come in and out of the house, the nurses and the doctors. But I mean, I'm too busy for that. I've got all the form filling to do for the government here. So I don't think it's becoming part of the natural caring philosophy of everybody else. Because one thing, I say this very strongly, I don't think I had the monopoly of care. I think every other doctor and physician from the surgeon in Edinburgh cares about the patient and cared about the patient almost as much as I did. All that I said was, well, I've got an aptitude for that time of life and that faith. But I think there's a danger that the doctors, for example, are not often, they don't spend as much time in the palliative care unit because they're also doing a consult in the West and they're doing somewhere else. It's changing in that respect. It's also changing in that the nurses that are going into the thing are more academically trained than everywhere before. And as you probably know, Edinburgh had the world's first degree in palliative care nursing, Queen Margaret University College. The first degree, not just as an interest topic subject, but now, for example, it's in Columbus where I used to be, more than half the nurses have got degrees in that subject, which is really quite something. They're very highly trained, and of course very good. So will it do all we wanted it to do? I don't know.
But you have formed a body of knowledge and experience mm-hmm. that is feeding other areas of medicine.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And of course, increasingly, it's no longer a cancer-related specialty. It was for a long time. Incidentally, not because we wanted it that way. People have often said to me, why did you never accept other people? The answer was, it would take anybody. You could have sent a cardiac failure patient or a chronic obstructive pulmonary disease or neurological, any of these patients, and we would have been equally happy, maybe not as familiar with it ourselves. We were still learning that, but it was never meant for cancer only. So yes, it is there, but I'm not sure that it's not just going to be subsumed and eventually lose some identity. I feel very strongly, though, that palliative medicine had an identity of its own, which is no credit to it, but I think it had some unique features. And as I've often said to audiences, and we are not the unique feature, I don't think it does that unique, we were just ordinary people that were taught to care. But I think the unique thing is that we live in a society where loss and death is, and loss in any form, is something to be avoided. I mean, loss and deformity never did anybody any good. Because of an interest in history, I think I'd say, well, not quite true. I don't want people to be deformed or harmed in any way, but in fact history shows that a lot of the people that were contributors to society, to the world, have in fact had chronic illness or deformity or deafness or whatever, and God forbid that we should wish that upon them. But having loss doesn't necessarily mean disaster, and yet I think we live in a society which is thinks that anything to do with loss is a disastrous thing. Palliative medicine says it's not. It's painful, yes, but it's not a loss. In fact, we can grow as a result of it. I think the ability to listen to people is something which is being lost in our society. In palliative medicine, people cannot function unless they know how to listen. Listen and really shut up. This is not a happy climate for... How can I put it? Old-fashioned medicine. A lot of palliative medicine was modern drugs, modern techniques, but maybe a bit old-fashioned. In that you did sometimes sit and listen to patients. And I didn't go around holding hands a lot, but I think it was a rediscovery rather than an invention. And that probably sums it up. I'm not sure that now people are not more interested in p-values for everything. There are still some things, and I happen to go on record of saying this, I would like to have hard, robust, scientific evidence for everything. I don't know how you measure love. I don't know how you measure compassion. I don't know how you measure that weird, inexplicable empathy that we have to show. And to me, palliative medicine is companionship with people in the last, final, very lonely journey of life. When, quite frankly, they don't want anything said. They just want somebody there that cares. Somebody who's not interested in his own esteem or importance, but just wants to share his or her companionship with somebody else on life's road. Sounds a bit romantic, but that's it.
Thank you very much. I think we should just, we can do better than stop there.
Thank you very much.